Today we are going to take a look at how to upload data and review the upload within the QPP portal. First step we're going to do is navigate to qpp.cms.gov and sign in using our credentials based off of our account information. From here, we are going to agree that anything we are submitting is true, accurate, and complete. Once approved, you can see we are hitting the landing page where we have the option to begin reporting. So once I click on start reporting, I'm going to navigate down into the group that I wish to report for and click on report as group. Once I've clicked this, I'm taken to the reporting overview page. For this group, no data has been submitted, and as you can see, none of the information is currently populated. From here, I'm going to click on upload a file, which then from here, I'm going to click upload. This specific file that I have uploaded did contain an error. At this point, you can see that the file was not processed correctly, and I do have the ability to download the report to tell me what is wrong with my file. I open up the file. You can see that the issue with this specific submission had a problem with the performance start or performance end date. So we go back through, we fix this, and then let's say we want to upload the correct file. From here, click upload, and you can see that the upload was successful. At this point, you can click on either upload more or view submission. Once I click on view submission, you can see that the data associated with my submission has been populated on the page. We also have a notification letting us know that all changes are saved automatically as well as when it was last updated. So we have our preliminary score, our quality score, promoting interoperability, improvement activities, and cost will be NA as that information will not be available until after the submission period closes. Additionally, you can see here that we're prompted with a notification that the score will not be final until the summer of 2020. For quality, the main update is the fact that we have collection types associated with the way the data is actually processed. In previous years, it was broken out into different submission methods where each one of those would be calculated and compared. For this year, the information is all contained within one scoring, and our submission type is then notified within the measures itself. So you can see for this measure, it was reported via the ECQM, whereas this measure was reported utilizing the MIPS clinical quality measure specification. Similar to in previous years, we have our performance rate, our measure score, as well as the details associated with each one of the measures that's available. We have our sum for all of our measure points, and then also the information that's associated with our category score, bonus points, total maximum points, and our category weight.